The Microsoft 365 Defender APIs are moving to the Microsoft Graph Security API, which you can now use to automate workflows and integrate apps with Microsoft 365 Defender. Apps authenticate with Microsoft Graph by using OAuth 2.0, and after authentication, it returns an access token that the app uses to access the API. Apps use REST to invoke the API and exchange information by using JSON. To make this work, your app needs a few things. First, it needs to support OAuth 2.0. You also need to register the app in Azure and create an application password for it. And the app needs the Azure application ID and your tenant ID. Last, you need to decide whether the app will run as a signed-in user or as a background service or daemon. Of course, you can use any language that supports these standards to develop your app. In my example, I'll use PowerShell. As mentioned earlier, the app needs to be registered in Azure AD. So, in App Registrations, select New Registration and type a descriptive name. Selecting a redirect URI is optional. In my example, doesn't need it anyway. Finally, select Register to create it. Just creating the app registration isn't enough. Now I need to give it permission to access the API. In API Permissions, select Add a Permission to get started. First, select Microsoft Graph, and then choose between Delegated Permissions or Application Permissions. If you don't need the app to run as a signed-in user, select Application Permissions. Then, select the permissions the app needs. Least privileged access is always best, so select the minimum permissions required by the app. My example just needs to read incidents, so I'll choose the Read All Incidents permission and select Add Permissions. One last thing here. Every time you add a permission, you must select Grant Admin Consent for it to take effect. Another requirement for accessing the API is an application secret or password. So on the App Registrations, Certificates and Secrets page, select New Client Secret. Then type a description and select Add to create it. Make sure you copy the secret to a safe place because you'll never see it again. Also, on the App Registrations Overview page, grab the application ID and the directory ID. We'll need both to use the app registration in our PowerShell script. That's coming up next. This PowerShell script is an example that gets incidents from the past 48 hours. I'll go through the major sections one at a time. The first part initializes variables with the data we got when configuring the app registration. I've already pasted these values here, so as not to bore you. The next part signs into the app by using OAuth 2.0. The access token in the response is what the script will use to access the API. Next, the script defines a variable containing the start of our time range, the current time minus 48 hours. And we use that variable in the query URI. The first part includes the API version. For pre-release APIs, use beta. For production APIs, use V1.0. Of course, we discourage you from using pre-release APIs in production apps. That's followed by the path to the Microsoft Graph resource we're using. In this case, that's security/incidents. The last part, everything after the question mark, contains the query parameters. In this case, we're asking for incidents that have been updated since the time we defined earlier. If you've never used Microsoft Graph before, this might seem like a lot. But we have some great documentation that describes in detail how to use the API. After defining the URL in a variable, the script then defines the web request headers. And the moment we've been waiting for, it submits the request to the API and stores the response in a variable. Those results are JSON, so the script goes on to extract the incidents. And the remaining bit of script outputs those incidents to a JSON file in the current directory with a unique file name. Of course, this very simple demo isn't very useful, but how you use the API to manage your organization's security is limited only by your imagination. We encourage you to learn more about using the Microsoft Graph API to integrate your app with Microsoft 365 Defender. For more information, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.